Nomad sculpt, and it does some animation. If I go over there and hit play, so there's a few steps to getting this out of Nomad and into this format, which is a USDZ. So let's go through that now quickly. So this requires a few things. You need Nomad, of course, and you need Procreate, and you need something called Reality Composer, which you can download free from Apple. So let's go into Nomad. So here's a sculpt that I made a while ago, and let's say this is what I want to export. So for this to work, you need the color and roughness and metalness maps baked into textures. The poly count has to be reasonable. You can see this is pretty crazy dense. And we have to export this all out as a OBJ. So let's go through those steps. So the first thing that I do is I'll go to the hierarchy and I'll choose everything and I'll just merge it down. So just choosing everything, whoops, that is the entire list. No, it's not, more things there. Make sure to avoid the lights and grab the tube, and I'm going to join it all. So wait for a bit, and there we are. And I'm gonna delete the lights. And I'm gonna, Mr. Cylinders, I'm gonna join that as well. So there's all our stuff, and I'm going to save this with a new name. Save as Swamp. Oops. Export. Okay, so that's all merged down. Next thing we'll do is I'm going to decimate this. So I'm going to turn off the post-processing just so it runs a bit faster, and turn off the background so I'm not distracted by that. There we are. And I'm going to go to the topology menu over here, the fourth icon across the top, and going to go to the deci/EV, and going to set the triangle count down to 50%, and I'm going to turn on wireframe, and I'm just going to keep tapping that until the wireframe looks reasonable. So I'm going to go decimate. Oh, and again, and each time you run, obviously it runs faster still. So I found, broadly speaking, I'm looking to get the target count down to under 20,000. It seems to run okay on most iOS devices. So we're at 186, I can see there. Go again, 93, 46, one more time, 23. That feels pretty good. So if I turn off wireframe, you can see still got most of the curvature information there, but the poly count is quite reasonable. Okay, so now that we've done that, we can now generate some UVs. So back in the same menu set, going to go down to Unwrap Atlas, so this big button down here, going to press that, and we get some UVs eventually. Cool, so those are UVs. And then we want to also now bake the vertex color and roughness information into the textures. So we'll click Bake Vertex Painting. That's done. Now we can preview that by On the bottom toolbar here, I'm going to tap this UV button, the last button, and we can see that's the colors. And just to double verify, we can go up to the lighting menu up here, and if we turn off Show Painting and Show Textures, you can see that's just the raw shape. But if I turn on Use Textures, that's what's saved into the texture maps. So that looks like it's in a pretty good spot. So now we have to export this as an OBJ. So I'm going to go to the File menu. I'm just going to save this now. Okay, and now I'm going to go down to Export, and I'm going to choose OBJ, and I'm not going to export vertex colors. I am going to export normals, and I'm going to export textures. So I'm going to go Export OBJ, press the big button, and I'm going to Save Files, and I'm going to put it into a subfolder under Export. So this is just in my Nomad folder, and that would have gone in there. So now I can jump out to Files, go to where I saved that, which is in my Nomad folder, export, and there should be a swamp export. So you can see that this has an OBJ file that doesn't have a suffix, an MTF file, and a textures folder that has my base textures. So I can look at that and just confirm it's all there. The roughness map is there as well. So now to bring this into Procreate. So if I jump over to Procreate, and I'm going to use the little three dots at the top of the screen, and tap it, and go Split View, and we're going to split it with the Files app. So we are. So now from here, I'm going to go to the folder above, so I can see this Swamp Export folder, and we're going to drag this into, so you had to long hold on it until it lifts up, and now you can drag that into the Procreate gallery. So if we wait a bit, and you get a new canvas there. And now I'm done with the files app, so I can drag the divider away. Go into this new canvas, and you can see there's our model. So if I use my finger to rotate, you can see he's all there. If I want to verify the maps, I can open up the layer stack, open up on the base layer, I can click on this little cube icon, and I can see there's my maps. So that is good to go. So the next thing we'll do is we'll export a USDZ of this. So I'm going to go to the gear menu, and going to go, where is it, share, and I'm going to share a USDZ. And I'm going to save that, saved files. And I'm going to put this into a folder which I've called Reality Composer, so just so I can find it later on. Now this file as is, you would be able to load that directly into iMessage and other AR views, but the scale is often too big. So what you need to do is you have to use something else to scale it down. And I found Reality Composer is actually a pretty good way of doing that. So I'm going to fire it up down here. You can see it's this icon in the bottom, in the middle of my toolbar down the bottom. Here we are. So I'm going to go back to projects. I'm going to create a document. And the one thing that you need to do when you first download it is you have to enable USDZ export. So if you go to settings and find Reality Composer in this list and enable USDZ export like that. Okay. Now again, back to Reality Composer. Choose what kind of AR experience this is. So I'm going to go horizontal for now. And I'm going to click the plus and the top toolbar there to bring in something else. I'm going to click plus again to import a model. And I'm going to import this swamp export. And now I can choose this one, and in it comes. Now by default, it's probably going to be enormous. Where has it gone? Or has it gone tiny? The scale is often a little bit hard to follow. Let me just make sure I actually brought it in. Where's my outliner? Whoops, I brought too many of these things. Undo. So I just got the one. I can find my frog. Oh, there he is. He's behind me. So you can see that default cube is roughly a 5 centimeter cube, about the size of a Rubik's cube. So this is way too big. So I'm going to center him on the stage, and on the iPad, when you choose it, you can bring up the transforms. You can see here on the right. So I'm going to scale it right down. So I'm going to scale it down to, I'm going to use my tap the number and make that be 1%, maybe 2%. Cool. And then I'm going to set the position to 0. On Y, so that should drop it to the ground. And now if I zoom in, I can see it's a much more reasonable size. So I'm going to use the blue arrow there to drag him forward, then pull him up, and maybe that is a bit too small, so I'll use the scale slider to make it just a little bit bigger. Maybe say that big. Cool. Reality Composer has a handy feature that as you drag things down to the ground plane, it will snap onto the ground like that. So that's now the right size. These other elements here are models, so you have to press them and then press it again and hit delete. And same with this select edit thing, that's a sign, so I'm going to select it, select again, hit delete. Okay, so now that's good to go. Center it up a bit more, like that. Now from here I can preview that by pressing the AR button at the top, and I can zoom and have a look. There he is. So that's pretty cool. So turn off the AR button. So now I can use the menu button in the top right, the three dots, and go export, USDZ, export. And I can now save to files, or I can send it directly through message to someone else. The other thing that you get with Reality Composer is basic interactive functionality. So I can choose the model again, and go to the arrow with the dots in the top right there, the third icon from the right, and you get basic behaviors. So I could say that this thing that I'm going to go a custom behavior, so that when the scene is started, then this model will do something. So I'm going to maybe say spin. So I'm going to press where it says affected objects, and choose the model. And I'm going to make it rotate 5 times in about 10 seconds. So now I'm going to play it, you can see it does what I want. So that's the basics of getting Nomad models out and into AR view on iOS.